Hey there, it's Annette from Easil and welcome to another DIY design tutorial. Today I'm going to talk to you about all things menus. So creating food menus, wine lists and cocktail lists for your bars, cafes and restaurants so that you don't need to go back to a graphic designer for every little small change that you've got. So let's jump into Easil and I'll show you how. So we're going to get started by searching for a pre-designed menu template. So typing in menu in the template search field here and scrolling down until we find one that we want to work with, and then clicking on this thumbnail to open it up in the Easil editor. Now that I've got that open, I'm just going to zoom in so that I can show you a little bit more detail about this. So as you hover across each of these menu columns, you'll notice that they're made up of individual table cells. So as you click through, you can see that there's different sections of each one of these menu item components. So for each menu item, we've got a heading area, we've got a price area, a description area, and also over here, there's a secondary price field. So these are the same for each one of these fields. And what that means in Easil is that you can actually go through and type in your menu content, tab across to the next one, reformat that content, go to the next section by tabbing through, and so on. So it's very quick to go through and reorder any content or add your new content onto an existing menu template. So this is the easiest way to get started because everything's already formatted. And with these tables, you can go in and you can quickly reformat the existing content into your own style. So going into this cell here, I've got this existing font, and if I want to change that to my own, I can click on any font, and what you'll see is that it's actually formatted that in the same font all the way down through that menu content column. And you can do the same with any of those cells. So I'll just do the same thing with this font here. And you'll notice that again, that has very quickly changed every single cell in this column to the new font. So that's a really quick way of taking an existing menu template in Easil and updating it to your own fonts. You can take that further by updating any of your colors. We'll just pick something really bright there so you can see that that applies as well, or any of your other formatting. So letter spacing takes it across all of the cells within that column. Also, you can change, again, you can change font sizes, anything like that you can quickly do throughout that one table column. Now, I'm going to show you, I'm just going to delete some of this other content, and I'm going to show you how you can build these sorts of tables from scratch and so that you can understand how to take them up a level as well. So you can find table elements in the right sidebar here. So if you click on graphics and then go down to tables, you'll see all these different row configurations. So if I click onto this existing menu here, you'll notice that this one over here gets highlighted. So this is made up of those four different cells that I explained earlier, and it's highlighted here that there's the four there, but we've got all these different other ones. So there's single cells, there's double rows, there's a half and half, and further down there's some cells that have got a description area and two price columns and three price columns and some other columns the other way around as well. So as we add these table configurations to our menu, we can actually snap them together. So I'll just start doing that to show you what that actually means. So starting a new table, if I click on any of these and just add them, it will add onto my menu and it's starting a new table. Once I've got that new table, either this one or the one I'm working on now, if I've got that clicked and selected, I can bring across different row configurations as well. I'll show you that shortly. But first of all, I'm going to work through and show you how you can take this table that's unstyled and turn it into your own branded and designed styled table configuration. So clicking into any of these cells here, I can go in and select my font. I can apply my font size. And I can do the same again for my pricing field there and clicking down to the bottom row as well. I'm just going to change that color to black as well and apply body copy font. And I will make that a little bit smaller. And the same with that field there, though I'm actually going to delete the content from there. So the hardest part of building your menu is actually creating that first styling from scratch. I'm just going to delete that. So now that I've got that table set up, what I can do is actually go through, click into my first cell, type my content in, tab across, put my price in there, tab down, and put my menu content or my menu item description in, and then tab across to my last field, which I'm leaving blank because that's just a secondary price field. So I'm going to click down to add a line space at the end here, and that is the end of formatting that section. So now that I've got all of my styling applied how I like it, all I need to do is click on this plus symbol to create more of those rows. So I can fill up my menu with the amount of items that I want with that same type of formatting, and then I can simply go through and start typing in, or you can copy and paste your content from somewhere else. Simply go through and enter your content, tabbing across to each individual item. And that's your first stage of your menu completed. Keeping in mind that if you want to change the formatting of any of these sections, if you do so in one of these cells, it will carry it across to all of them within that one type of menu configuration. If you want something different in terms of styling, for example, if you've got a special meal or some sort of call out that you want from your chef, you can snap across different types of row configurations from this right side. So currently we've got that one there with the four different cells, but what I want to do is add in a different styling. So I'm going to drag across this one here, and this one only has two cells. So with this type of menu item, you might want to do a special chef suggestions or something like that that's different from your ordinary menu items. And by designing that menu item in a different way, it will stand out more in your menu. So let's just say reef and beef chef's special, tabbing down to the bottom and configuring that with the center alignment as well. And then you could type in a description there, which, look, I'll just put some placeholder text for now, but make that a little bit smaller. But what you can see is that with that type of formatting, you can make something really stand out in your menu as something different. So any type of different formatting, so your higher GP items, if you format them differently, they really pull your customers' eyes to that item. So make sure that you do maybe one or two high GP items as feature items within your menu. So you can style them like this. And if you wanted to, you could take it a little bit further and go into your shapes as well. And you could either add a colored shape behind. So if you grab something like this, apply some opacity to it and reduce that box size down and fit it just across to that menu item. Send it to the back. Then you can actually have a really standout sort of menu item. You can also go through then if you wanted to, and you could change that coloring to make it stand out and be reversed out depending on the sort of colors that you choose. Alternatively, you could choose something like a box like this and drag that across and outline individual items as well. But you will notice that if you do one or two of these on your menu, it really does make your special menu items stand out. So along with that, the other things that you can do with this type of menu configuration is you can quickly resize your columns just by dragging this in and out like that. You can also pick them up and move them and duplicate them. So this top arrow allows you to pick them up and move them wherever you like. So quickly moving them wherever you want to position on your menu. You can also copy and paste them onto different pages so that if you're wanting to create a matching cocktail menu or wine list or dessert menu, you can create exactly the same look. But within this menu, we want to create three columns. So I'm picking that up and doing a duplicate of that and positioning it next to my column here. Now, what I want to do as well is I want to take off my menu titles from the side here. And I quickly want to reformat all of my text to be in my dark blue color. So there we go. We're back to the colors that I wanted to have on my menu. And what I want to do is actually put my titles into the tops of these. So I'll just show you using the tables feature again, how if you've got this selected, you can drag in another type of row configuration that you haven't used in your menu already. Pop that in there and you can resize that and restyle that to however you want that to be. It's a little bit too small. I'll call this share plates and entrees. Now with that cell selected, you can use the line height to create a little bit more space as well, so that that's actually separated out from your menu items. And I'm just going to, I might make that 26, so it's a bit bigger than the rest of my text, and put in a little bit of letter spacing so that that stands out. So now within my table here, I've actually got the medium text row configuration. I've got this second type of row configuration with the four cells, and I've got my chef's special, reef and beef chef's special. So I've got three different types of rows snapped into the one table that I can manage and move independently from anything else. So with my box here behind, I'll have to go to my layers here and I could just nudge that down. If I make any changes, just move that to highlight my food special. Normally I would add that type of stuff at the end once I've formatted my whole menu, then go through and pick those items and highlight them at the end so that you don't have to be messing around with moving those highlight boxes. So that's pretty much how tables and menus work in Easil. You can add all of these items on, and when you finish, you can go across to the graphics tab. You can bring across any other graphic elements, or you can even go into your layouts tab. And if you wanted to bring a different type of layout into your current menu, you can click on these available menu layouts. Make sure that you click add as a new page. And what that will do is bring that in as a secondary page. And you can always go through and pick one of those sections either by using these columns here and copying and pasting them or dragging them onto your current menu, or you can select the bits and pieces that you want to use. So for example, if you like this configuration here, you could click through and select all of those items and drag them across onto your menu. So I'll just go through and show you how that works. So say if we were having a call out section here that we wanted reversed out, and we want all of this section here, we'll go steaks, that table and the background, and the cow. So you can select those via the layers panel as well. Drag and drop that onto my current menu and pop that into place. Now you can go through and use that same highlight way to make this one stand out as well. So I'll put my brand colors in. I'll go through here, and what I'm going to do is reverse out all of this content that's on here. Just making sure that you click off to apply your colors. So there you go. So you can start with a completed menu template from Easil. You can configure your tables from scratch by using them from the graphics tab and the tables panel and dragging and dropping those layers until they click together for each column, so you can manage them as a full column. Or you can bring in different components of menus by using the Layouts tab on the right here, bringing them in as a different page and then dragging and dropping them and making that, building your whole menu out of the different pieces from different menus and just using your own fonts to go through and make it your own, just like that. Thank you so much for watching today's video. If you enjoyed the content, please consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell. And if you've got questions about creating menus or using tables in Easil, let me know in the comments below and I'll get back to you. I'll catch you next time.